Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another video from Lingling. Today we're going to talk about everyone's best friend here in China, also known as WeChat. Staying in China just for a few hours, you already know that WeChat is like the most used app here, and basically the app can help you with all aspects of life, literally, in China. So without further ado, let me tell you 22 things you can do with the WeChat app. So because it's a texting app, obviously you can talk to people, text people, you can also send voice messages, which is very popular here in China. So instead of writing stuff, you just record your voice and then the voice message is sent to the other person and they can reply with voice or they can reply texting. Number two is you can also make a phone call or you can make a video call just like Skype. Thing number three you can do with WeChat is that you can send your friend pictures, videos, your location if you can't find each other. You can also share location so you can find each other, which is really cool. You can basically send everything. You can also send red envelopes, which is a Chinese thing. So for Chinese New Year, people send red envelopes with 8 kuai or 8.8 kuai or 88 kuai or 800, you get the drill. Really cool thing. Also, you can transfer money to your friends. If you just went out eating and your friend paid for the meal, then you can transfer money to them immediately. Like this. Thing number four is that you can pay in shops and restaurants. Also, a really cool thing, that's thing number five, is that when you're in a restaurant, instead of trying to get the waiter's attention, you can just find the shop, scan the QR codes on the menu, on the table, and then you can order on your WeChat, and then it will go straight into their system, and you don't even have to try to talk to the waiter. Another really cool feature is that you can scan the barcode of a product in a store and then the WeChat is going to tell you if there is a cheaper option nearby or how much it is online. Thing number seven is that you can also, just like on Facebook, share your pictures and videos and articles with your friends. So it's called WeChat Moments. And people can like your pictures and all the things you're sharing and they can also comment. Okay, feature number eight is really funny because basically it's made so you can shake your phone and if somebody nearby you is shaking their phone at the same time, you will get a match and then you can start talking. Number nine is really cool because you can see the people nearby you, the people you don't know. You can actually search specifically for guys or girls, so it's kind of like a date app, but like in a more relaxed way, I think. So you can see who is nearby. I don't know, I feel like it's a little creepy sometimes because if the person is like 50 meters away, and like for me, because I look foreign, so I always have my own picture, my profile picture, so I feel like people, they instantly know if I'm there. I don't know. But anyways, that's feature number nine. Another way to also find new friends if you're alone. I actually did it once in Germany. I found a person nearby and we went to a museum together and that was pretty cool. Then we have feature number 10. Number 10 is shopping. You can do shopping on WeChat. WeChat is linked to other companies, so you go through WeChat to another app or website and then you buy through there, but you pay with your WeChat. So basically if you do shopping on WeChat, it will take you to JD.com, which is another huge, really popular app and website, shopping website here in China. Feature number 11 is games. You can go and find your favorite game, you can purchase it, and then you can play games with your WeChat app as well. Number 12 is that you can charge your phone. If you don't have more money on your phone card and it's complaining, phone card, SIM card? I don't know. Then you can charge it with WeChat, you just click charge 50 kuai and bam bam bam, and then your phone is working again. Number 13 is really, really an amazing feature. I love this one because I can find a taxi nearby me. So if I'm in a place and I can't see any taxis around me, I can basically just open up WeChat and it's gonna find a taxi nearby and it's gonna call the driver and he will come and he will call me and say, oh, I'm here now, and then I'll just jump into the taxi. And again, I can pay with my WeChat. Number 14, again, is something kind of like shopping. So I can buy plane tickets, train tickets, hotels, all of these things I can book and buy them on WeChat. Feature number 15 is really good if you're in school because you can transfer files. Actually, WeChat has a web edition as well, a computer edition, sorry. So you can put your WeChat, you can log onto your WeChat on your computer, and then you can transfer files between two parties. And also, actually, our professors, they all have WeChat. So instead of emailing them, we just used WeChat, and they also send out the homework and the readings for the different classes. They send all of those on WeChat as well. 16 is also really cool because you can pay all your bills, like your monthly bills. So if you have like a water fee or like electricity, internet for your apartment, you can set it up and it's all gonna automatically pay. It's basically like a bank inside a texting app. One thing I really like is feature 17, because right now in China it's very popular to use nicknames for WeChat accounts and also put a profile picture of like a cute dog or Superman or somebody else. So it's really hard for me to figure out who is who. Like, I don't know who my friends are anymore because they changed their pictures and their names. What to do? Well, feature 17, you can actually change their names. So maybe they call themselves Little Rainy Cloud or something. Chinese are very poetic sometimes. I can just change it to their real name, and then every time they change to another nickname, it's still gonna be their real name when I see it. So I don't see that they change the nicknames, I only see the real name. This is a great feature for me. Number 18 is really cool because right now we basically have everyone on our WeChat. So I was thinking like, oh, I kind of want to post this picture, but I don't want my boss to see this picture, or like my blah 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 to see this picture. So you can make groups of the friends that can see the pictures you're sharing, and groups where people can't see. I think that's really, really cool. Also with like comments and such, you can decide who can see them and who can't see them, and people from outside can't see your comments if you're commenting on other friends' pictures. Number 19 is also really cool because you can track your packages. If you bought something online, you can scan the barcode on the little receipt you got, and then you can see where is your package and when is it gonna arrive. Number 20, feature number 20 in WeChat is that you can send digital postcards to your friends and family. Number 21 is also really cool because a lot of people they use these funny small gifts, like pictures of like crazy, what is that called, like emotions or people. I will put in here so you can see what I mean. So you can save all these funny objects and gifts, and then you can send them out to your friends as well, and it just makes texting so much more fun and lively. It's really cool. And the last one, number 22 on our list today, is that you can access WeRun or Weixin Yundong, a sports app inside the WeChat app. Again, you can track your steps, how much you're walking, and your exercises. It's really cool. One lady, she told me about this a few weeks ago. Anyways, guys, I hope you liked this little video. I hope it wasn't too long. Please give me a thumbs up for this video, subscribe for more videos from Lingling, and comment, what do you think about WeChat? Is WeChat going to be the next big thing all around the world, or is it only gonna be in China? I hope it's gonna be the next big thing all around the world, but we'll see. Let me know what you think. I'll see you again very, very soon. Lingling's out. See ya and 再见.